genius new product that lets you crack open eggs.
Oh, hello. I was just working on a multi-million dollar lawsuit.
Imagine if electrical power suddenly went out for millions of people. And not just for hours, but for months, maybe even years, throwing our world into chaos, crippling everything from communication to food and water distribution. It sounds like the start of a post-apocalyptic movie, but there's a real possibility that it could happen. It's called a low-probability, high-consequence event. A massive solar storm could knock out electrical power and wreak havoc on nearly every aspect of modern life. But it's not something we're really preparing for, because for most of us, it just doesn't register as a big threat. But here's the thing. It's happened before. If you were around on September 1st, 1859, it would have been a pretty weird day. As the sun set, the night sky lit up with a brilliant light show. These were auroras, electrically charged particles from the sun colliding with the Earth's atmosphere. And they were so bright in some parts of the world, you could read a newspaper outside in the middle of the night. And you could even see these auroras as far south as Hawaii, where they had never been seen before. And what little electronics we had back then, well, they suddenly went haywire. Telegraph lines overloaded and threw sparks, even lit telegraph paper on fire. This was the solar storm of 1859, often referred to as the Carrington Event. And if it happened today, well, it could knock us back 100 years, to a pre-electrical age. So, what exactly is a solar storm? It's basically a catch-all term for when the sun erupts a bunch of mass and energy into space. And it usually starts with sunspots, cooler areas on the surface of the sun that form over areas of intense magnetic activity. And it's these sunspots that are tied to an increase in phenomena known as solar flares and coronal mass ejections, or CME for short. Solar flares are energetic explosions. They can blast enormous amounts of energy and particles towards Earth. While a lot of it is deflected by the Earth's magnetic field and atmosphere, solar flares can still interfere with communications and navigation systems. But it's a large CME that can cause real chaos for modern technology. It's an eruption of the sun's magnetized plasma that is then carried to Earth by solar wind, where it can overwhelm the Earth's magnetic field. All of this activity tends to peak about every 11 years or so, and a flurry of particularly bad solar flares and CMEs can cause real havoc to our electrical systems, potentially throwing large parts of the world into darkness. We've had glimpses of what this can do to modern technology. In 1989, a CME much smaller than the Carrington event hit Canada's province of Quebec, damaging electrical transformers and leaving 3 million people without electricity. And we had a pretty big scare in 2012. It looked like a CME, on the scale of the Carrington event, might hit Earth.
The electric power grid would be wiped out by the current. Lights and computers, transportation, hospitals, all would go down. The study warns it would be a disaster, far worse than anything we have seen before.
It ended up passing through Earth's orbit and missing the Earth by a margin of 9 days. But had it hit us, we might still be picking up the pieces, years later. Geomagnetically induced currents could have damaged hundreds of high-voltage electrical transformers, all at the same time, crippling our electrical grid. And it's not like we keep a bunch of spare transformers stored away somewhere. It would take months or years to fully repair and replace damaged infrastructure. And the consequences of that? Far-reaching and devastating. The problem is, the cost of protecting our electrical infrastructure, from a Carrington-level event, would run into the billions. But at least we'll see the next one coming. Our ability to monitor the sun's activity is improving quickly. We're now collecting data on everything, from solar wind, sun oscillations, to changes in the sun's magnetic field. We'll now have some warning before the next Carrington-level event happens, and that might give us some time to prepare, kind of like we would for a major hurricane. We could preemptively shut down electrical systems, or even large portions of the grid. But all of this would take serious coordination between government and private industry. And there's been some progress on that too. Countries around the world are taking the threat more seriously. There's a bill before US Congress to further improve solar storm observation capability and to better coordinate the response of agencies if one hits. It's not a matter of if, but when the next one hits. It's been 150 years since the Carrington event. Maybe we can take some comfort in the fact that it might well just be another 150 years until the next big one hits.
stupid. That damn CNN always trying to get me scared about some.
You want to call that?
All right.
By the way.